Eye-catching circular animations that fill with vibrant colors when you hover over an element are one of the sought-after effects these days. In today's video, we will break down the process step by step and create 5 stunning variations of icon hover effects using key CSS properties like transition, transform, and the at property rule. This is Optimistic Web, where we explore the world of CSS and front-end development, one step at a time. In the HTML, we have a bunch of anchor tags, each containing a social icon, and all are wrapped inside a parent container. And by the way, I am using Bootstrap icons for this demo project, but you can choose other resources like Font Awesome, box icons, or even your custom SVG images. As always, the CSS is ready with some basic styles for the page. Let's start with the container. Actually, the social class doesn't require any specific styles for this project. I am just using that to keep the icons center aligned, and Flexbox is a super easy solution to make that happen. The next thing is the anchor element. Once again, Flexbox is used to maintain consistent alignment for the icons. The aspect ratio property, set to 1, ensures the element becomes a perfect square, and border radius transforms it into a circle. To create the circular animation, we will use the before and after pseudo elements. Since both are positioned, they'll need a content string and a z-index to position them lower in the stacking context. The inset property, with a negative value, allows them to expand beyond their original boundaries. Let's fill them with a conic gradient. The first color in this example goes all the way from 0 to 100%, and the second color starts immediately after. Since the first color completely covers the area, the second color has no visible space left. If you're unfamiliar with the current color keyword, it represents the current value of the color property applied to an element. You can check out this detailed video to explore further. Then comes the hover state, which is quite straightforward. It's only a change in the color value. The focus visible and focus within pseudo classes are there to support keyboard users. I have another video on focus pseudo classes that explains when and how to use them. Coming back to the topic, to animate pseudo elements from their starting point to the end, we need to manage color stops in a way so that the gradient smoothly transitions from 0 to 100% and then goes back to the starting position in the same way. So instead of hard coding color positions, we can define CSS custom properties using the at property rule. This rule gives us precise control over the definition of custom properties. It allows us to specify a data type, set a default value, and control inheritance. And the best thing is that these properties are fully animatable. In this example, the custom property will accept only percentage values, can be inherited, and has an initial value of 0%. With this setup, we can replace the hard-coded values with the custom property. Next, we will use the nth child pseudo class to target anchor elements based on their position in the markup. For example, the nth child one will select the first anchor tag. When this element enters a hover, focus visible, or focus within state, the custom property will update to 100%. And then the transition property is all we need to animate the change. What is happening behind the scenes is that the value of the custom property transitions from 0 to 100% over a duration of 0.6 seconds. To visualize this clearly, let's temporarily comment out the z-index property. Notice how the conic gradient begins at 0% and animates to 100%. Also, for the first variation, we don't need the after pseudo element, so it can be set to display none. The second variation is similar to the first, except for the direction. By applying a 180-degree rotation on the y-axis, we flip the pseudo element and create a counterclockwise animation. Once again, the after pseudo element is hidden. Moving on to the third one, this time the custom property is updated to 50% instead of 100%. The after pseudo element is flipped on the y-axis, while the before pseudo element remains in its original position. This results in a bi-directional top-to-bottom animation where the first element animates on the right side, the second on the left, and they meet at the bottom center. The fourth version takes the lead from the previous one but switches the direction. This time, the animation flows from bottom to top while still using the 50% mark. In this variation, the after pseudo element is flipped on both axes. Finally, the last variation also uses a bi-directional approach, but with an alternate flow. The before pseudo element moves from top to bottom, while the after pseudo element travels from bottom to top. To refine this effect further, we can add a transition delay of 0.3 seconds, and then reset it to 0 in the hover state. This way, the transition will be slightly delayed only when the element exits the hover state. The effect will trigger immediately upon hover, but will wait for 0.3 seconds before transitioning back to its original state. And that's all for today. We have covered 5 awesome icon hover effects using CSS, each with its own unique twist. I hope you're feeling inspired to try these out in your projects. If you learned something new today, don't forget to like, share, and subscribe for more front-end development tips and tricks. Feel free to leave your questions or comments below. Thanks for watching, and see you in the next one.